Today, we are going to discuss regarding the topic hospital pharmacy and its organization. So, today's point of discussion will be the definition of hospital pharmacy, then what are the objectives of hospital pharmacy, functions of hospital pharmacy, organizational structure of hospital pharmacy, then what is its location and layout, then what are the space requirements as well as the personal requirements in a hospital pharmacy, and what are the requirements and abilities of a hospital pharmacist. So first we are going to see with the definition of hospital pharmacy. So a hospital pharmacy is a department of hospital only which deals with sessions like procurement means simply buying of materials, storage, compounding, dispensing, manufacturing, testing, packaging and distribution of drugs. So all this process will be handling in a hospital pharmacy. Other than these functions, it also plays an important role in education as well as in the research projects. So all the researches and the education, that is continuing education program, will be provided by the hospital pharmacist in a hospital. Then hospital pharmacy is generally controlled by a professional qualified pharmacist. The main objectives of hospital pharmacy is to ensure the availability of right medication at right time, the right dose at minimum possible cost. So whenever a hospital pharmacist is making whenever there is a hospital pharmacist, if we are dispensing a medicine, that medicines should complies with the prescription, and along with that we should guide the patients. It has to be taken in a right time, and the dose of the prescribed medicines should be matched, and the medicine should be of low cost. Then another objective is the pharmaceutical services in a hospital should be professionalized manner. Then it also acts as a counseling department for medical staff, nurses and for a patient. Now counseling is not only to the patients but also to all the medical staff as well as the nurses, that is CME programs. Continue medical educations can be given to nurses and medical staff by a hospital pharmacist. And moreover, the duty of a hospital pharmacist is to provide counseling. Nowadays, clinical pharmacists are also appointed in hospitals just for looking this matter. Another objective is to act as a data bank on drug utilization. Next, to participate in research project, I said earlier. The other objectives include to implement decisions in pharmacy and therapeutic committee. So this is one of the main objective of a hospital pharmacist, that is the senior hospital pharmacist should indulge in the decision making in PTC committee. PTC means pharmacy and therapeutics committee. The next objective is to coordinate and cooperate with other departments of a hospital. So as usual in every field, so we have to coordinate and cooperate with the other professionals. Similar way, the hospital pharmacy should also coordinate and cooperate with the other departments in a hospital. The next objective is to plan, organize and implement pharmacy policies in an established hospital. So it is the duty of the hospital pharmacist to indulge in those processes also. Next, we are going to discuss regarding the functions of hospital pharmacy. Hospital pharmacy helps to provide specifications for the purchase of drugs, chemicals, biologicals, etc. Then proper storing of drugs, then manufacturing and distribution of medicines, examples, transfusion fluids, parenterals, tablets, etc. All this manufacture and distributions of medicaments is also another function of hospital pharmacist. Dispensing and sterilization of parenteral preparations which is manufactured in the hospital, then dispensing of drugs as per the prescriptions of the medical staff of the hospital. So doctors will be prescribing the medicines. It has to be dispensed in a proper manner. So it is the duty of a hospital pharmacist to dispense the medicines. The senior hospital pharmacist will be looking after whether all these processes are done in a proper manner. The other functions include filling and labeling of drug containers from which medicines are to be administered. Example in case of fluids. Then management of stores, which include purchase of drugs, proper storage conditions, and maintenance of record. Maintenance of record is another important function of a hospital pharmacy. All records regarding the purchasing, stocking has to be maintained in a hospital pharmacy as a record. Then establishment and maintenance of drug information center. So drug information center, it is a recently upcoming program, that is hospital will be having a drug information center with well equipped clinical pharmacist there or hospital pharmacist. They have to provide information regarding drug. So when the patients are coming, they can ask queries directly to the pharmacist present there in the DIC, so that all the queries of the patient related to the drug will be cleared from DIC only. If not, the patient can query through, if phone numbers are allowed, the patient can query through their cell phone also. So all mostly the DICs will be of 24 hours. So queries can be done by patients or medical staff or any other staff who related to drug can be enquired with the pharmacist present in the DIC or drug information center. Providing cooperation in teaching and research programs. Then discarding the expired drugs and containers which is worn out and missing label. So all those things, the expired drugs as well as if the containers are broken or something happened, everything has to be expelled from the hospital pharmacy. That is also duty of a pharmacist. Next, we are going to discuss regarding the functions of hospital pharmacy as a whole. So we have already seen the main functions are dispensing. Then other functions include purchase and inventory control, then statistics, reports, and manufacturing. Then besides teaching, research, and overall control and coordination should be there in a hospital pharmacy. So under dispensing, the drugs can be dispensed into outdoor patients. Outdoor patients means where the patients are coming into hospital after taking the consultation with the doctor. The prescriptions will be given, they can buy the medicines from the hospital pharmacy and just they are going back to home. So such patients are known as outdoor patients, just patients are coming and going from a hospital. But inpatients means the patients, those who are admitted in the hospitals. Then the other areas of dispensing include medical, surgical, laboratory supplies, ward or floor stock, alcohol, etc. Dispensing of alcohol, registers, etc. has to be maintained in the pharmacy if alcohol has been dispensed. Then manufacturing. So in case of manufacturing, the drugs can be manufactured as bulk, large volume parenterals, small volume parenterals, etc. Pattern of setup of an hospital pharmacy. So hospital pharmacy, there will be a director or dean or medical superintendent.